दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 10, 18th सेंचुरी पॉलिटिकल फॉर्मेशंस. दीज आर सर्टेन पिक्चर्स रिलेटेड टू द चैप्टर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कम बैक व्हेनेवर दिस इज रिक्वायर्ड. आई विल ट्राई टू कवर थ्रू दिस क्वेश्चन ऑल द चैप्टर हियर. द ब्रिटिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी एस्टैब्लिश इट्स पावर आफ्टर. सी द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी केम, बट द क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट पावर. Okay, when it came, it is not asking. When it established its power, so the answer is 1757. Aurangzeb had depleted the military and financial resources by fighting a long war in the. So Aurangzeb was a very, very powerful ruler, Mughal emperorship. Now he was very strong and he would not allow anyone to come up, and those, because Akbar reign, Humayun reign, Jahangir reign, there were different say the Rajya or the communities which were against Mughal rule. They were inside them, but they wanted to come out, like the Marathas, like the Jats and the Sikhs. But here, this is the boundary I'm showing you of 1700. This whole area, this is a very big area. And this big area was controlled by the Mughal emperors. So it is not easy to control them. There will always be certain factions, certain prans, certain rajya, certain state who are against them, or they will always try to come out of this Mughal empire. So you can imagine that this Hyderabad is in Deccan. So this is the Deccan region. So he has to fight a lot of wars, small wars, and in order to stop them or to resist them, he put a lot of money and financial resources and all the resources others which he had. So when Aurangzeb died 1707, it was almost a finish of Mughal emperorship or the Mughal empire. So Mughal emperor which came after Aurangzeb, they were very weak. So Deccan is the correct answer. Now Aurangzeb died in the year, so I just told you, so 1707. This you have to remember, and you will remember why, because 1707 is a very important date, because after this there was change, very rapid changes in very small amount of time. So this is 1707, Aurangzeb died, and after that the depletion or the down curve of this Mughal empire took place. 1761 there was a war, and that also changed the course of the game. What is that war? Just let me know if you know. It's a letter Panipat, okay? Who fought? So 1707 is the answer. Ahmed Shah Abdali was the ruler of Ahmed Shah Abdali. So he was, because let me show you the picture first. This was the subcontinent. So there were people inside, there were people outside. They were always, quarreling, fighting, war, and all these things were going on. So people knew that India is Sone ki Chidiya. India has a lot of money, resources, or this subcontinent. So Ahmed Shah Abdali, or Durrani we call him, he is Ahmed Shah Abdali. Just see him. He is Ahmed Shah Abdali. He is the person we are talking about. And he attacked after Nadir Shah. Nadir Shah attacked once. But he had a Panchavarshiya Yojana, Ahmed Shah Abdali. He came 5 times in 13 years. 13 saal, 5 bawal. You can remember like this. Ahmed Shah Abdali invaded North India dash times between 1748 and 1761. What is the answer? Now it's quite clear. 1748 to 1761, it's around 13 years. So in 13 years of span, he attacked or he invaded the subcontinent 5 times. So as I was saying, that why these people were invading, why the English people came, and why they tried to grab the power? Because India in the Mughal reign, it became Sone ki Chidiya. It became so powerful in terms of power, in terms of resources, in terms of the administration. India had something to, or this subcontinent had to offer, had a lot of things to offer to the international community. And Ahmed Shah Abdali, these were the rulers. So they wanted the money or whatever they for the which they came. During which century the Mughal Empire declined? Which century? Now, let me tell you how the century is devised. 1707 he died, Mr. Aurangzeb died, remember, 1707. Now 1707, let me tell you, if your age is 21, how do you say the age? Because if you are 21 plus, you are not 21, you are 22, right? You are 22. If you are 21 year and one month, you are not 21, you are 22. So this is how the century is also computed, calculated. So 1707 is not 17th century, it's 18th century. We are talking about 1700 to 1800. So 18th century we are talking about. Today what is going on? It's 21st century. It's 2021. So 2020 or 2021, that means we are talking about 21st century. But we have not reached 21st century. Because 100 years passed, that is a century. Century means 100. So this is how this 18th century is the answer of this question. So 21st century we are in, 18th century, though it happened in 1707. Which of the following enjoyed the Zat rank of 7000? So two of them who created Awadh, Bengal and Hyderabad, they were having 7000 Zat. 7000 Zat is a very strong rank in the Mughal court. So they were right hand and left hand of Mughals. So Awadh, Bengal, Hyderabad, there were three people who made them. Let me show you the pictures. So he is Saadat Khan. Okay, remember him by Awadh. Murshid Kholi Khan, you can remember him by Murshidabad, because Bengal capital was Murshidabad because of his name, Murshid. And Asafzah, let me tell you Asafzah for the Deccan area. Okay, so Hyderabad. So Asafzah Hyderabad, Murshid Kholi Khan Bengal, and who is Saadat Ali Khan? Basically, Saadat Ali Khan was having less Zat rank, 6000. But Asafzah and Murshid Ali Khan, they were having Zat of 7000. So both of these is the answer. Who were the Telugu warrior chiefs? Now Nayaks is the answer here. So I'll just tell you, when Asafzah controlled the political and the military power here, so he created this Hyderabad, and he was in constant resistance and fight with two directions. Okay, in his left, that is what we see here on the screen, left it was Marathas, on the right it was these Nayakas. Who was the powerful governor of Bengal? As I said, Murshid Kholi Khan, because Murshidabad, this is how you remember. So 7000 Zat he had, he was very powerful at that time. So that is how he created whole Bengal. And I'll tell you about these three. All of these became Mansabdar. They started with the Subedars and Mansabdar, but was not there. During whose rule Jagat Seth became prosperous in Bengal? Now Jagat Seth, you can remember that day, Ambani. Means the time we are talking about Jagat Seth. At that time, Jagat Seth was the Ambani of the area. So it was Murshid Kholi Khan. No, after Murshid Kholi Khan, there are other rulers also came. So it was Ali Wardi Khan. Who is the answer? Ali Wardi Khan is the answer. He was creating these, you know, good nexus between bankers, etc. Sawai Jai Singh founded his new capital here. Who is Sawai Jai Singh? Two names are coming. In this chapter, we have discussed about two people, Sawai Raja Jai Singh and Ajit Singh of Marwar. Sawai Raja Jai Singh and Ajit Singh of Marwar. Now, these two, they were having control of certain part, that is Jodhpur and Amber. Now they wanted the other places also from the Mughal raid, because they were close to Mughal raid. So Sawai Raja Singh founded the new capital in Jaipur. Actually, the Amber area is a big area in which Jaipur is there. So you can remember that Amber area by Jaipur. So we are talking about Sawai Jai Singh. Dal Khalsa was set up in 1699 by. Dal Khalsa means what? It was a combination of the people who were in the Khalsas. So 10th Guru, Guru Govind Singh Sahabji. So these Sikh Gurus were, you know, you must respect them. They gave the Indian community a lot, right? So Guru Gobind Singh Sahab, 1699 is the answer. Small political groups of the Sikhs were called. Now, there were big groups and small groups because the Sikhs were divided into different groups. Big groups, small groups, political groups basically, or fighter groups or warrior groups or some ideology they have. Now, these small groups were called as Misl. And what is the big group? What is the name? Can you just give me the answer? Okay, let me tell you, it's Jatha. So, Jatha is the big group and smaller group were Misl. Big group, small group. These are the small political groups of the Sikhs. Answer is Misl. Okay. So, this is how, you know, finally Ranjit Singh came and he combined and made the capital in Lahore. And this is how, and in between we have, Banda Bahadur also. Chauth was the dash of the land revenue. The Hindi people know this Chauth means Chautha. Chautha means 1/4. So, this is 100. If you take the percent, 100%, so 25% is the answer. 25%, right? Chautha bhag. Who was the founder of Maratha Empire? So, Maratha Empire was founded by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Shivaji Maharaj. With all respect, you know, Maharashtra, even a whole country, they respect him. He was a powerful leader, you know. Chhatrapati, Shivaji adopted the title of Chhatrapati. Now, why this Chhatrapati? Chhatra means shelter. Let me give you a very, very naive example. This is a Chhatri, this is an umbrella. So, umbrella is called Chhatri. Now, Chhatri, that is if you are standing there below this, you are being sheltered from the water or sun, hard sun. So, Chhatrapati was actually a guardian, Abhibhavak, Sangrakshak, controller, ruler of that region which he controlled. And people respected him. People loved him a lot. That is, he was called as Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. And many other also got this Chhatrapati. Tax levied by Maratha was called. Now, the tax. Now, let me tell you one important thing. See, all these rulers which we don't like today, which we like or not like, we WhatsApp message, Facebook, we know everyone that he was bad, but that is bad. But this is history. Everyone, every powerful ruler, every ruler has to get money. They are not doing any work. So they will just take the land through war, killing people. They will take the land and then they will levy tax. They will ask for the money for that particular land or some transaction. Or for anything, because they need money for their power, for their army, for their political satta, for their, you know, different matters. So this tax is levied by Marathas or anyone else. But the Marathas, they will call as Chauth and Sardeshmukhi. Okay. So the tax levied by Maratha, the answer is here is Sardeshmukhi. And what is the Sardeshmukhi? It was 9 to 10% additional tax than Chauth. See, Chauth was already there. Chauth is 25% you have to give. Chautha part, 1/4. If you have 100 quintal, give us 25%. 25 quintal. And then, because the Deccan is the area of these main area of Marathas. So, 1/4 they will take Chauth. Along with this, they will add one more tax, that is 9 to 10% of the produce. And that is called Sardeshmukhi. So, it was around says like it, you give income tax and upar iske laga diya jaye your education tax or cleanliness tax or say corona tax. These are additional to what tax you are giving. Under whose leadership Bharatpur emerged as a strong Jat state. Bharatpur is, let me show you the region first and the area name of the person also. So Agra people know very well, Mathura people know very well, even the Delhi people know very well where is Bharatpur. So this is the Bharatpur area. And it's very clear to Agra. That is why you find so many people of Agra as Jats. So this region, Bharatpur, it became very powerful under the reign of, under the rule of, under the leadership of whom? It's Suraj Mal. The answer is Suraj Mal. Don't get tempted for Chudaman. Chudaman answer question is coming. So Suraj Mal is the answer. Let me show you the picture. He is Maharaja Suraj Mal. You see the beard. He is so powerful. Maharaja Suraj Mal, okay, he was highly respected. Now, match the content. Now, just give me the answer, how many you can match? Because Sadat Khan, Murshid Kuli Khan, Asaf Jah, we discussed a lot. So, Asaf Jah, Hyderabad, Murshid Kuli Khan, Murshidabad, Bengal, go to Bengal, Sadat Khan, now Awadh, Lucknow area, okay, Ijaredar, they were land revenue farmers, यू कैन रिलेट देम विद द बटाई बटाई वन, दे विल टेक अ लैंड एंड दे विल से ओके विल गिव यू दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, वट एवर वी डू इट इज अवर प्रॉब्लम, टैक्सेशन और यू नो रीअसेसमेंट, बट दिस मच अमाउंट यू आर गोइंग टू वी विल गिव यू टू द रूलर्स एक्सेट्रा, 500 rupees फॉर मंथ, एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेकिंग. नो राजा जीत सिंह एंड सवाई राजा सिंह, दे वर ऑलरेडी रूलर ऑफ द यू नो पार्ट ऑफ दिस अंबर एंड जोधपुर. सो अजीत सिंह ऑफ मारवाड़, दैट इज द एरिया विच आर टॉकिंग, यू नो द मारवाड़ एरिया एरिया एंड सवाई राजा जय सिंह. सो दीज टू यू हैव टू रिलेट विथ दीज टू मैच द फॉलोइंग. सो दिस इज दीज टू दे आस्क्ड फॉर द सुबेदारी ऑफ सर्टेन एरिया फ्रॉम द मुगल एम्परर. मुगल एम्परर एक्चुअली गेव देम टू वेरी बिग एरिया. व्हाट इज द आंसर? राजा अजीत सिंह गॉट गुजरात एंड सवाई राजा जय सिंह गॉट मालवा एरिया. This is the answer. Okay, so let me show you the Malwa and Gujarat area. This is the Gujarat area, and next to it is the Malwa area, Malwa region. Ujjain or Ujjain, these area come here. So Saadat Khan, he was the founder of Awadh. Mushid Uli Khan, Bengal. Asaf Jah, Hyderabad. And Ijaredar, revenue farmers. Ajaj Ajit Singh, Gujarat, and Sawai Raja Jai Singh, Malwa. Now fill in the blanks. Third battle of Panipat. So third battle of Panipat, I told you that you can give me that answer, but it is 1761, and the third battle of Panipat was fought between Marathas and whom? So this was fought when? Ahmad Shah Abdali. Now whenever Marathas were so popular now, but at that time they were just attacking different, grabbing different areas. So there were some people who are not very much interested in them. They were not happy. You know, Maratha and they were fighting in Panipat. So there are certain people who are against them, who didn't like their approach or the way they were increasing the empire. So they supported actually Ahmad Shah Abdali. It was basically the fight between Marathas and Afghans, Ahmad Shah Abdali, and Ahmad Shah Abdali is the face. So it was happened in 1761 that changed the course of the game, and the Afghans win 1-1. Rule of Iran plundered the city of Delhi in 1739. So Nader Shah is the answer. As I explained to you earlier, that 1739, and then came Ahmad Shah Abdali. So this two I'm talking about. So NS came, that is Nader Shah, or 1739, and after that Ahmad Shah Abdali, he came five times, 13 years, five times he attacked. So this is the ruler of Iran we are talking about. He plundered, attacked, invaded the city of Delhi in 1739. The answer is Nader Shah, remember? Okay, so he was Iranian. Mughal nobles were divided into two factions, dash and dash. So Mughals, the Abhijat were of the nobility, they were divided into two factions, two ghettos. One was the Iranians, and the answer is Iranians and Turanis. So one is Iranians and one were Turani. Turani was what? Turani means Turkish. They were Turkish. So Turanis are Turkish, Iranians are Irani only. So they were divided into two factions, and as we know in history, various different people, they tried to take benefit of this, and they became closer to one of the faction, and they got so many mansabdaris, etc. Revenue in Bengal was collected in cash. Okay, so it's cash, no kaid, only cash. So see, remember Shivaji Maharaj. Now Shivaji Maharaj was the ruler, and the prime minister, or he, the power of the administration was with the Chitpavan Brahmins, and they were called as prime minister and the administrator basically, and they were called as Peshwas. So the prime minister of Shivaji Maharaj and those who came after Shivaji Maharaj as the ruler, they were called as Peshwas. Basically, prime minister of Shivaji and the people who came after Shivaji. Sisav Rakhi offered protection to cultivators on payment of tax of dash of produce. So, as I said, that everyone has to take tax If they don't take tax, how do they rule? So 20% is the Rakhi. I'll tell you about Sikhs. So Guru Gobind Singh, after Guru Gobind Singh, Banda Bahadur, he was actually ruling and taking resistance or resisting the other rulers, especially the Mughals and the Rajputs. So he also wanted money. Everyone wants money for their army and etc. So they levied a tax, and that tax was called as 20% Rakhi. Rakhi. This is the answer. Rakhi is the answer. That is, we are going to protect you. If you give this 20 quintal from here, we'll give you protection. Now, the right and wrong. Nobles appointed as governors by the Mughals had no control over Diwani and Faujari. This is absolutely false. You know, these three, what they did, Saadat Ali Khan or Murshid Quli Khan or Asaf Jah, what they did, they took control of the Faujari Diwani, that is the political matters and the army matters and the money matters. So army and money, these two are called Faujari and Diwani. So they took control, that is how they were able to form these three big states. Ahmed Shah Abdali invaded North India five times between 1748 and 1761. This we have discussed earlier also. Yes, it is true. They 13 years, five times he came. Ahmed Shah Abdali. So 1748 to 1761 is 13 years. Banking house of Jagat Singh became extremely popular during the rule of Murshid Quli Khan. No, he was that time Ambani, but it came later to that. Murshid Quli Khan, after that Ali Wardi Khan came. And Ali Wardi Khan, under his reign, this Jagat Seth, basically the bankers and merchants, they became powerful. Khalsa was instituted in 1699. Absolutely true. Ranjit Singh was important leader of Marathas. No. Ranjit Singh is Sikh leader. Maratha, Shivaji and others. So there is no relation. So it's false. Ranjit Singh, actually, he did a very good job. The Sikhs were divided into different factions of leaders. So he combined them, reunited them. Actually, he reunited them. Because previously, Misl and Jatha was there also. They were also united sometime. But he reunited and made the Lahore as his capital. Ranjit Singh is Sikh leader. Jat consolidated their power under the leadership of Chudaman. Is it true or false? Chudaman. So, let me show you the picture. He is Veer Rav Chudamanji. Veer Rav Chudamanji. So, Jats consolidated their power under the leadership of Chudaman. It's absolutely true. Consolidation means sthapit karna, making, okay, creating. So this is all about this question and answer. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.